Been a while since I streamed because I've been sick as a dog. I took some awful cough medicine hoping it would help, but it really hasn't. So we'll see how this goes. I adjusted my mic settings a bit for OBS. I hope it won't be so muffled now. So we'll see how that goes as well. I know Petras had a side quest he wanted us to do, so we'll see what he wants.
I need to speak with you, my child.
Yes, Petras. What is it?
I've come up with a plan to put what we've learned about the Mother Cardinal to use.
Do tell.
You will have to take part in a fight in the arena, and we must make sure that the odds are high. To do this, you'll have to face a champion. This will lure her in.
That would effectively raise the odds. But the risk is they'll bet against me.
That may be the case. But the highest bets are based on the exact time of the defeat.
I see. We are going to make the Mother Cardinal believe that I will lose at a specific time.
And by doing so, you'll win something bigger than a fight.
This will make her lose a considerable amount.
Exactly. I've even taken measures to make sure her usual moneylender is unavailable. Without knowing it, she will come to me looking for gold in order to place her bet.
And she will be at our mercy. Is this how you settle scores in Delaney?
This is how all scores are settled, my child. Or on the battlefield. But that's much dirtier. So, what do you say?
Put that bitch on ice.
It's a complicated plan, but an effective one. Let's put it in motion.
Let's go back to the St. Matthias bookmaker. Your skills seem to interest.
Welcome. You here to wager? To fight?
I want to challenge the champion of the arena.
A champion? Really? Now, you were asking about Candy King. It wouldn't be him that sent me here by any chance.
No, no one has sent me. I'm looking to make a reputation for myself.
Ah, that sounds better. You know that in order to attain supreme glory, there are a few rungs on the ladder. None of my champions will make a trip to fight against someone barely known.
Even if I promise that the spectacle will be worth the journey.
No one cares about promises. Prove yourself in the arena and win at least the third challenge, and people will start to listen to you.
Very well. We'll see each other again soon.
At least you have the right attitude. That's summit.
I'll do that then.
I will leave you alone until your reputation in the arena is established. There's no point in me following your trail for days.
So I think days, let's take the next one.
It could take some time.
Let me know if you need me.
Of course, Petras.
I've killed like, what, 20 foot tall guardians. I don't think I can handle anything they throw at me, can I? A little bit of healing would be nice, Petras. Is that the right? Yeah, I always have the crappy but pretty close for some reasons. Hit and run, hit and run. Just like that. I eat these things for breakfast. Oh.
I need to get going.
A pity. Well, come back again soon.
There's a champion. I want the champion.
Good day. Welcome. You here to wager? To fight? I've done what you asked. Can I have my fight now?
I have to admit that you've surprised me. You have technique and style, and the public does love you. Let me think. There's Briscard, one of our old champions. He's not a youngster anymore, but his name is known. And he's a killer. I'm warning you.
This Briscard sounds like the perfect opponent.
Sounds like a bitch.
I'll work on getting things ready for the combat and line up the betting. Until then, make sure you're ready. It'll be a duel. Your friends will need to stay in their seats. As soon as you're ready, you'll just need to go and see the arena master.
We should go and see Candy Cane so he can set up our deal. So when you win, she will lose her bet.
Yeah.
You again? What do you want this time?
Why so defensive? Petras, you have a proposal to make, I believe.
That's right. I've thought of a little scheme that could make us very rich. You know me, so you also know I'm quite clever, and that my ideas are always fruitful.
They do say that you are devious. Perhaps too much so for your own good. Go on.
My friend here loves the glory and sand of the arena.
I've gained quite a reputation. Soon I'll be taking on a true champion. I'm no fool, though. I know I won't last long against him.
Yeah, I've seen the odds. Everyone expects you to lose within a minute. So what?
Let us suppose that our champion is a little less aggressive than usual.
If the fight can last at least 5 minutes, an informed bettor would win the jackpot.
And I'd keep a little of my pride.
Very well. I'll arrange it. No dirty tricks. Don't take advantage of the deal and try to beat the champion. If you do, he'll wipe the floor with you. You want to get your money. Don't get too greedy.
I think there was a Seinfeld episode of one like this, wasn't there? If I recall, something with a fixed fight. Take a dive.
do you seek?
I have come to tell you that we have taken care of the Inquisitors and set the camp's prisoners free.
You thought we weren't capable of fighting the Soul Lesser and of freeing our people?
No, I didn't.
That's not it. I thought it was my duty to inform the woman who represents Teleme here of the situation. She's the commander of the Soul Lesser, and she was furious when she heard about their actions. She made a point of punishing them herself, and of having your people set free as a token of good faith.
I understand. She's proven a respectable queen. And you have proven an ally. I thank you for your help on Almanawi. From now on, you have our gratitude and our trust. From this day forward, you are a garant of our clan. Anything more?
So I lost reputation and I gained 4 reputation. It's a good trade.
I need to be going.
For our own sake.
Yes, yes indeed.
Sarte. I'm the legate of the congregation, and I was sent to find a young Nort, Albert.
That dirty little eel slipped through my fingers. But this savage will soon tell me where to find her.
What do you say, Petras?
I see you folks at the Ordo Luminis are as subtle as ever. Why politely ask when we can resort to torture,
Only missionaries believe that these savages would help us without encouragement. But why are you concerned by my methods if you're looking for this young woman too?
I do not like the idea of leaving a trail of blood behind, Johannes. The case that sends us here far exceeds your petty mission. So you'd better leave.
I made a commitment to find this young woman and bring her back to her father. I will not give up so easily. I have been promised a substantial amount of money. And I care about my reputation.
Huh, your reputation? Your order has already lost the support of the Cardinal Mother for interfering with the Norts. And here you are again involved in their business. You're putting nails in your own coffin, Johannes.
I didn't see it from that angle. Well, I'm going back to San Mateus. I leave you this savage. Have fun.
Oh, I will. Come on, savage, what you say?
May the grass be forever soft under your feet, Renice. I thought I was dead. He would have killed me, even if I had spoken.
You're probably right. Do you think you can answer us? We also have questions to ask you.
You saved me. I owe you answers. But first, I have to go back to my village.
Sure thing, Skippy. Great timing that was.
To excite the crowd. Ah, there you are. I was told you'd be taking on one of our old champions. Are you ready for the fight? Beware, Contrary to the challenges, this combat must be fought alone. Your friends must remain in the stands.
Well, I've been outnumbered on everyone so far anyway, so it'll be a good change of pace anyway.
Yes, I am ready.
So, jump into the arena, and may the better fighter win.
So I gotta last for like 5 minutes. Do I have to edit this out? I could kick this guy's ass. This is a joke. Does that actually say I'm supposed to... It says I'm supposed to defeat the champ. Okay, turns out the game keeps running when you bring up the stupid menu, so that's nice to know. Oh my god, fucking idiot, move! Won't the candy cane be pissed off at us, though? Oh, Mother Cardinal. It'd be funny if it wasn't really her. That'd be hilarious.
Lord de Sarte. And you, Petras. What can I do for you?
We have come to offer our support. We have learned that the arena was cruel to you.
How do you know that? Oh, I see. You tricked my informer.
You just let him believe that I would lose.
All I did was take the place of your moneylender. You owe me a handsome sum.
All of this just to make me spill the beans, am I right? I didn't expect you to play this kind of game, Your Excellency. It is cheating.
Oh, come on, Cornelia. You excel at this game.
It's true. And I also know when to admit defeat. What do you want from me?
We won't use what we know of you, nor what you owe us. So long as you act loyally towards the congregation and Constantine. Is that clear?
Is that what you're expecting? Ah, but I'm sure that this sly old fox has something else in mind, right? You hope that I'll support you when you court the rank of cardinal. You haven't learnt your lesson then. Have you forgotten the abyss into which you plunged because of your ambition last time?
Petras, what is she talking about?
Cornelia, you don't have the right to use that against me to disclose what I revealed to you that day.
It was said under the seal of the enlightened, it's true. But if someone deserves to know, it's him.
No, please.
Since you have no intention of speaking, I will. Petras knew your mother, child. Your real mother.
My mother? Petras, is this true? How?
Be damned, Cornelia. It's true. I used to go to the jail to give my spiritual support to the prisoners of the Prince d'Orsay. That's where I met her. She was alone, afraid,
uncle lied to me and you kept quiet.
I was ashamed. Ashamed of having left her to die in that dead-end pit.
Why talk to others about it then? Why does she know?
One evening, in a fit of despair, Petras felt the need to share this great burden with someone.
At the time, you were the ear of the enlightened Cornelia. You have broken your vows. Ah, oh, damnation.
You're all terrible.
It's better out in the open. I've wanted to tell you about it since I met you. Now that you know, I want to do something in her memory. I will help you find your family here on the island. The prince sent you here to use you. But I can ensure that all of this serves a purpose.
How could I possibly believe you now? You have used me for your scheming and kept me in the dark.
I understand how you feel, my child. Let's wait a little until you've taken it all in. Time heals the wounds of the soul. Come back and see me when you are ready. As for you, Cornelia, remember what we have on you. You no longer have the upper hand.
Be careful, De Sarte. You now see the real Petras, sly, an opportunist.
Dangerous old man. Alright, Petras, you have to stay behind and clean the house. We go have an adventure as punishment.
You are the ones who saved me from soul matter. I am so grateful to you. I owe you so much. But you wanted to ask me questions.
Alba.
We're looking for a Nort girl. The same one that the Inquisitor is looking for.
But I promised Alba to say no. I would really like to help.
And you risked your own life keeping your promise. But Alba is in a very delicate situation. If we do not find her first, others will track her down, and they will kill her without letting her defend herself.
So she was right to be afraid, poor girl. She came here saying she was being chased. Boy led her into the forest nearby to a cave where she could hide. If you have one of your notes, I'll show you where she is.
Thank you.
Did you want anything else?
I must go. Goodbye.
Bit of poison on my brain. And let's go! Let's see if you can ward off this
He's a chonker. Give him some healing, just be a pal. more armor. Thanks. What a poison bomb. We got him, we got him. Hell yeah. Or not focusing. Focusing. What's over there anyway? What were they trying to hide from me? Rich merchant's key. Found this key in the body of a merchant of the Alliance. The man seemed to have fled long distance. The belongings must be somewhere upstream of the river. Good to know. The Cave of Death. I remember this. No, sir. Skills to pay the bills. Strong grip. Here we go. Slaughter, is this?
Maybe these are Albert's things.
What things? What are you talking about?
No, you will not get me. I will not go back to the convent.
Then you die. Do I have to kill her? What? Yeah, just run her through. That's what we should do.
Let alone take you back to your father.
So then why are you here?
We know you betrayed the Nauts who took you in. You stole documents from your captain to sell them to the highest bidder. And we're here to pick them up.
What? I never did such a thing. The Nauts are the family I chose. I would never betray them.
There's no point in denying it. We found the dead drop that you used. We confirmed that you were negotiating to sell secrets. And Captain Reuben, who already suspected you, reported the theft of his book just as you were leaving town.
If you were innocent, you wouldn't have fled your crew.
But all of this is false. I don't even know what a dead drop is. And if I fled, it was to escape you.
Escape us? If you were not the spy, that makes no sense. You better tell us what happened.
Some time ago, Captain Morgan told me that he had been informed that my father had gone to Tearfield. He worried me. I knew my father would do anything to bring me back. Then, in New Serene, my colleagues told me that the Legate was looking for me. I was scared. I told the captain, who told me that I would find a ship in San Mateus to leave the island. But there were none. I saw my father at the tavern with one of his inquisitors, and I realized that my only chance was to flee deeper inland. A native helped me find this cave, and there you have it.
I can't believe it. Reuben used the mistrust of the volunteers to accuse her, and he used us to make her run away. Probably to hide the fact that he himself is the spy. We've been duped. We must return to New Serene as soon as possible and warn the Admiral before it's too late.
And what will become of me?
You will come with us. We will protect you. We'll need your testimony.
To Sarte, what can I do for you?
Our investigation is well underway. But the culprit is not who we thought.
What do you mean?
We found Alba, but she was innocent. In fact, her captain used us and her father to scare her. It's because of us that she fled. She never stole documents or tried to sell your secrets.
So, are you saying that the culprit is Reuben?
If this were not the case, why make up this story against Alba and use us like that?
I can't believe it. And to think that I believed his lies. However, he is a captain. I cannot condemn him without solid proof. And we have to find out who he was selling his journal to. Ask his crew, but stay discreet. It should not arouse suspicions. Anything else?
I need to be going. Until we meet again, Admiral.
You know, I would have killed Alba if I hadn't already slaked my bloodlust on that Forest Guardian fight.
Your Excellency, I am so pleased to see you again.
The pleasure is shared.
Captain!
Good day, Jonas.
What can I do for you?
What do you think of your new captain?
He knows how to make people obey him, and runs a tight ship. What else is there to say? He's a captain. I'm only a cabin boy.
Does he get on well with Alba?
He was suspicious of her at first, but when he saw that she was trustworthy, he treated her like one of our own. But when she disappeared, he told us that she didn't have what it takes to be a knot. He spoke of treason, that sort of thing. I imagine he regretted having trusted her at all. Anything else, Your Excellency?
I'm afraid I need to be going. Watch out for yourself.
Hello. You need something?
What do you think about Captain Reuben?
I know what it's gonna sound like, but I liked it better when you were captain.
Thank you. Heartfelt. But tell me why.
He's a good captain, but he lacks team spirit, if you know what I mean.
He's aloof, doesn't get along with his crew.
You're still far from the mark. To him, we're nothing more than lackeys. The only one who gets a smile from time to time is the pretty Gretchen, one of the girls from the tavern. She scratches his itch. As soon as he can, he's off to the brothel. Must cost him a right fortune. He should be careful. A debt with a coin guard is like sailing near a storm.
If he's a loner, it would make sense he needs some company from time to time. And as captain, he must have the means.
Yes, you are certainly right. Well, none of my business. Anything else?
Bros before hoes.
I need to go. Farewell.
Smooth sailing.
Good day. What can I do for you?
We have a few questions to ask you, Flavio.
I'm all yours, Captain.
What do you think about your new captain?
He is fair, decisive, and he certainly knows the sea. But he keeps
distance, as if he wasn't a member of our species. And since we got here, it's been worse. He seems troubled. The slightest disagreement puts him over the edge. But never mind me. It's not my place to judge my captain. He's got responsibilities I can't fathom. Anything else?
Fathom, because it's the sea, get it?
I need to be off. Perhaps we'll meet later.
Farewell, then.
Ah, she's right by the door. How silly of me.
Hello, my darlings. It's rare to see the upper crust in here. It would be my lucky day. Do you and yours want to have a good time? I could call a few friends.
I'm sorry, but I'm not here for that.
Really? What would you like, then?
Speaking of crust, what does it look like down there? Are you clean?
I was told that Captain Reuben liked you a lot, and that you spent a lot of time with him.
He's one of my regulars, it's true. He always asks for me. It's because I'm the sweetest.
Does he confide in you?
Sorry, my dear. But what's between my clients and me is nobody's business.
Offer her to become a courtesan. Sounds good.
How about a change of scenery and a chance to work in a more luxurious environment?
Become a courtesan? But don't you need connections to get there?
I'm the legate of the congregation and the governor's cousin. So?
Oh, I'm not stupid enough to miss such a chance. What do you want to know?
Did Reuben tell you about his relationship with his men and his superiors?
Oh, yes. He's always complaining about it. He was hoping for a promotion. He wanted to be appointed fleet commander. But they only changed his ship. And the crew is nowhere near his level. And his admiral despises him. He says everyone is unfair towards him and doesn't recognize his talents. And it has turned him bitter.
Have you noticed him change lately?
Yes. He's become impatient and anxious. He's become suspicious, too.
Did he tell you about his plans?
Like everyone else, he likes building castles in the air. He told me that he would soon be someone very important and very rich. And that he would marry me. But they all say that.
Thank you, Gretchen. I'm done. This fellow's a complete slime bag. How dare he be so ungrateful, as my ship he's collected. But, alas, we still have nothing concrete. We should follow him tonight. You never know.
I'm in love with the stripper. Manfred, talk to him. Let's go do that.
I was able to clarify the story about the ship, and we arrested the person in charge.
I've already been told all this. Lieutenant Alexander came before you did. He told me the whole thing, and he didn't fail to tell me everything we owe you. I have already sent a letter to the Admiral explaining what happened and offering reparations. I hope she will forgive us. Anyway, I thank you very much. Once again, you have worked wonders, Your Excellency.
We couldn't have done anything without Sergeant France. He showed admirable courage. I imagine he's joined your forces.
That doesn't ring a bell. I don't think a sergeant by that name is stationed here.
Strange. It seemed to me that Quartermaster Herbert told him to come and find you.
Well, perhaps he changed his mind. With this business going on, he must be sorely lacking in men. Anyway, know that our investigation has finally paid off. Lieutenant Alexander arrested many criminals with information obtained from prisoners. You should go find him. He's with Captain Ulrich.
Captain Ulrich?
The highest ranking captain in the garrison. He's an old man who is not often found in the field.
But faced with such a scandal, he had to intervene personally.
Thank you, Manfred. I'll go find him.
Yes, yes.
This arrest is good news. Let's find the captain.
Ah, Your Excellency. I was talking about your exploits to Captain Ulrich.
Your Excellency.
Captain, Lieutenant. Quartermaster Manfred informed me that you had made several arrests.
Indeed. Lieutenant Ermelind confessed, which enabled us to flush out most of the gang.
I can't quite believe all the arrested men are involved in this case. I know many of them. Could have sworn they were honorable people.
I'm sorry, Captain. I understand. It's a shock. We were all sure that our comrades would never be involved in this kind of thing.
Will you continue the investigation?
Of course. We can't stop our research until we've completely dismantled this organization.
Lieutenant Alexander was asking me to transfer into New Serene. To be a part of the investigation there.
To manage it. If you allow it, my captain. I was honored to participate in the interrogations of Lieutenant Ermelin, and to be able to arrest all these criminals. I would not want to leave things half finished.
As I told you, Lieutenant, I can't approve the transfer of an officer from another garrison. I must refer to the commander.
In any case, we're most grateful for your help. But we can now bring this investigation to an end without you.
I see. What goes on in the guard is the guard's own business.
It's a bit like that, yes. We can't let the actions of a small group compromise the reputation of the whole guard.
You forget, once again, that you have not yet obtained your transfer, Lieutenant. In the meantime, please be dismissed.
At your orders, Captain. Goodbye, Your Excellency.
So long.
Sorry, you had to hear this call to order. This Lieutenant is inclined to forget who he's speaking to.
It must be the enthusiasm of youth.
It's possible. In any case, and contrary to what he said, we will still need your help.
Why is that?
Lieutenant Alexander claims that Ermelin's confession allowed him to arrest all these men. But I attended one of these interrogations, and all she talked about was a secret camp. The one in which Torsten's recruits received their special instruction for the coup d'etat. If I understood correctly, this place was taken back and used by the criminal organization, but our lieutenant did not mention it, which surprised me, and led me to doubt his sincerity. Perhaps Alexander failed to report it to increase his prestige later.
But he could have another motive. So you would like us to go there?
Indeed. And I'd like to accompany you. I am no longer a field officer. I still know how to hold my own, and I want to see this case with my own eyes. You know the place, so you will be my guide.
Very well, Captain. You can count on me.
Thank you, Your Excellency. I will get going right away. Will you come with me?
Sure.
Yes, I'm ready. Let's hurry.
Join my party.
We're almost there.
How would you like to proceed, Captain?
By the book. We'll go through the whole camp, neutralizing any threat.
I don't know what the hell's going on. Recycled quests, ew.
It's blocked. Useless. They barricaded themselves inside.
Sons of bitches.
Bit of poison.
What? He's bad? Oh, that's our friend. Sorry, I tried to kill you. Didn't mean to. That's right. The younglings. All of them. Steel wallets, you say? Brown brigandine, you say? This?
Sergeant Franz. Poor man. He paid dearly for the help he gave us.
He was beaten to death.
Quartermaster Herbert ordered him to accompany Lieutenant Alexander to answer Manfred's questions, but he never made it to New Serene.
I was sure that the lieutenant was not genuine. He must be involved.
Send the hound to his widow. Up top. This list of names written by Egon. Must urgently do away with following people who have endangered our operations using all necessary means. Captain Ulrich in New Serene, Legate de Sarte in New Serene, Intendant Manfred in New Serene, Intendant Herbert in San Mateus. Sergeant Franz's name is also on this, but he's been crossed out.
This document talks about eliminating the witnesses to the case. Manfred and us are definitely on that list.
Sure.
It looks like poison.
Lieutenant Klaus,
You are part of this disgusting plot.
Lay down your weapons, Lieutenant. Any resistance is futile. Your troops have been decimated.
I will not surrender, Your Excellency. It's sweeter than the price of treason.
If you speak, we will be lenient.
You, maybe, but Egon, I doubt it. Farewell.
He's poisoned.
The plague. I'd have liked to have questioned that traitor.
Letter from New Serene at the attention of Egon. Our operations in New Serene had to be suspended after many of her men were arrested or killed, and the lieutenant in charge of the operation chose to take his own life rather than betray us. Intendant Manfred called on a member of the congregation, a legate, I think, who managed to make the merchant speak and discover our plan. What should we do? Awaiting orders. Unfinished letter. Madame Arzu, I regret to inform you that we will not be able to ensure the delivery of the natives we promised you. Unfortunately, the ship we had requisitioned was retaken by the knots, interrupting our delivery. Rest assured that we will do everything in our power to... Letter from Hikmet at the attention of Egon. Our operations in Hikmet ended abruptly after the intervention of a nosy legate of the congregation. Captain Ludwig was arrested, and Governor Byrne decided as to put an end to our operations. We deeply regret it. Could not do anything. Ludwig should have been more careful. Waiting for your orders.
These letters are signed by Egon. We must go to the office of the leader of these criminals.
We could study the handwriting to find out who's behind this. We did a good job, Your Excellency. Egon will never come back from a hit like this.
Certainly. But we know that there are still criminals amongst your troops, including their leader.
We know that Lieutenant Alexander is involved in all this. The sergeant's body, and the fact that he didn't tell us about this camp, are telltale signs. Perhaps he will be able to provide us with a lead. Otherwise, we still have these letters.
Remember that we are targets. Just like Manfred, we will have to stay alert.
You're right. Let's get back to New Serene as soon as possible. You'll hand over the evidence to Quartermaster Manfred and assure yourself of his safety. I will go and ask our insolent lieutenant for an explanation.
Yeah. We really should have bought Kurt for this, shouldn't we?
Dear cousin, come closer and tell me what brings you.
Constantine, is it true? Are you in great pain?
This sickness is horrible, believe me. Now I understand what your mother went through. But you have not come to hear my complaints. Speak, it will give me something else to ponder.
I wanted to inform you of our progress made in the attempt to as you advised. I followed the lead shared by our allies, none of which led anywhere. However, they both pointed in the same direction, towards a sort of god that the natives worship. They call him Enonmilfrictum, the god of many faces. He is very powerful and protects the island.
How can you be sure that it's not some sort of myth, even a superstition?
I saw it with my own eyes take shape during the ritual. It is possible that the Malachor is the expression of its vengeance.
You are referring to the secret we unearthed. The entire continent is paying today for the errors of our grandparents. It is a terrifying perspective.
But if it were true, he must also be able to help us heal.
Katasak, my friend. I saw you flinch hearing that name. You are familiar with this being.
All of the Donegard. Even in their flesh. He is dear for me. It is with him we make our bond. But why would we surprise the
is exactly what we did, cousin. I know that I ask much of you, but I have no choice. You need to go and find this magical being. I won't survive for much longer. Beg him. Offer him all that he wants, but we must have this remedy. I need it.
I shall do all in my power, Constantine, I promise you. But I need to find a way to communicate with him. I was already sent to fight a guardian under that pretext, and it almost killed me.
There is a way. A way so sacred that even we, Don Egada, cannot use it. Any mere flaking decides. It is not I who judges your intentions. Go and find Glendar, the sage of the village council of Dorhagen. If he deems you worthy, he will guide you. To be able to speak with him, you must present this seal. It will prove that you are the friend of a member of the council.
I had no idea that such a talisman was required.
You have not yet been named Mar of your clan, Seer, daughter of Blanek. When this has come to pass, we will give you a seal that allows you to give voice to your friends when visiting the council.
It is a symbol of great trust. Why are you awarding me this?
I do not wish to lose the soul who has put their life in my hands. And also, you have proven you are our friend back there in the village.
Thank you, Shalizak. I will not forget this honor you bestow upon me. And thank you, dear cousin. For everything.
You think he'd just stay seated the whole time if he's in that much pain? I know what the thing is. It's a unicorn, isn't it? We have to, it's tears to cure him. That's the twist. Unicorn tears.
Excellency, I wasn't sure I'd see you alive again. How did you know we were here? Did the captain tell you? He was arrested while coming back here. Lieutenant Alexander said he was finally reported by his accomplices.
That lieutenant has some nerve. We know he's involved. We found the body of the sergeant who was to accompany him here. He got rid of him to punish him for helping us, or to stop him from revealing more. We also found this document saying that everyone who knows about the case should be eliminated. You're in danger. And they've already found a way to get rid of the captain.
Most of the men who are loyal to him are in jail. I can't do anything without help. I've been trying to get the commander. If anybody can restore order to all of this, she can.
Here, take this evidence and show it to her.
Alas, there's nothing in there that clearly indicates who Egon is.
The recent actions of Lieutenant Alexander suggest that he is the brains behind this operation. And we only have to compare his handwriting with these letters to be sure.
I'm going to join the commander, but you should intervene. I'm afraid he'll get rid of the captain.
Arrest the real Egon? You say so.
The Sir, Your Excellency! What a joy to see you again. We finally stopped Egon. The captain will be happy.
Naturally. And that is why you are surrounded by the men I apprehend. We visited your secret camp and found the body of poor Sergeant Franz, who, in spite of his death, continues to betray you. You are a member of this organization, Lieutenant. And when we compare your handwriting to the letters we seized, it wouldn't surprise me to discover that Egon is none other than you.
We prepared a discreet death for you, worthy of your uncle's court. Little poison. And our troublesome diplomat would have been out of the way. But since you leave us with no choice, finish them. It'll be a real pleasure.
Finally, our revenge has come.
Now it's going to take a lot of poison.
Poison on my
off her, bitch. Cleave her torso right off.
No, no! Why did you have to stick your nose in our business?
If you had not been so careless, so eager to get rich and climb to the top, maybe we would never have discovered your operations. Surrender, Alexander. Unless you prefer Egon.
Let me go!
I could make you rich.
I doubt that the commander would find that arrangement.
I'm elite, I'm already rich.
Your Excellency, Lieutenant Alexander was court-martialed and will soon be executed.
You have my gratitude, Your Excellency. Without you, this assassin would have probably strangled me in prison.
Manfred gave me all the evidence you gathered and told me about the case. I'm just sorry he didn't tell me about it sooner.
My apologies, Commander. But you've been so busy since starting your new position. I never thought the case would be so big.
Be that as it may, the high-ranking culprits have been punished, and the foot soldiers will be sent back to the continent. A few months on the front should bring them back to reality. We owe you so much, Your Excellency. Without you, the guard would probably be nothing more than a band of brigands. I am extremely grateful. I will not forget what you did for us.
Don't mention it, Commander.
Serve to convince. Achievement unlocked. If you say so. Hunched over in the darkness, real spy-like. A little bit of looting, and you're doing some sneaking. Making a break for it. Man, I tell you,
here he is, red-handed. Set up. Shall we arrest him?
Yeah.
We should first find out what he puts in the box. Let him finish. The way is clear. Now, let's take a look at this box. his buyer should meet here at nightfall. This must be where the exchange will take place.
We should put the message in the box, so no one will know we've seen it.
And we should warn the Admiral immediately. She'd want to know.
Let's go.
Alright, Scooby Gang.
Sarte, what can I do for you?
We know a little more. Reuben continues to use the dead drop and has made an appointment with his buyer.
He has quite the nerve to continue using that box even though he knows you know about it.
He must have thought that we would not come back. The meeting is tonight. This could be a good time to get the proof we need. What do you think?
That's an excellent idea. I will come with you. I want to see this traitor fall with my own eyes.
Yeah, come along. We need a plus one. My Twitch looking. I'm always paranoid I'm gonna finish a video and find out it's all glitchy and buggy and I can't use it.
This position will be able to see the meeting discreetly.
Perfect. I can't wait to witness it. This traitor is going to find out exactly what it costs to make fun of us.
I can't believe it. This eel is selling us to the court.
The wretched traitor. How dare he sell us to lawless mercenaries?
It's sassy, Bass.
Have got what he deserved.
Is everything all right?
It's nothing. Sorry to have charged like that. I got carried away. I couldn't bear to see this traitor sell his whole family for a few coins.
Do you want us to tend to your wound?
No, I'll go back to port and get back on my feet. Find the documents. We'll see you tomorrow. Thank you, the three of you.
Over here.
In addition to a substantial sum, Reuben is also going to obtain a major post on the continent.
Not anymore. That's why I have an absolute.
Ready to sell more than just his own knowledge. There are plans for machines and ships that he must have stolen from elsewhere. Everything is here. We'll give it to the Admiral tomorrow.
Did you think I want points in endurance so I can wear the better armor. Vigor? Science? Old temptation of buff picking. That craftsmanship keeps on coming up again, doesn't it? For quests. I have scroll the secret.
Sarte, what can I do for you?
How are your wounds?
I recovered fast. It was nothing. Did you find the documents he intended to sell?
Yes, here they are. But there was more than just his journal.
So, he lusted after a prestigious position. And what a salary! I see that our secrets are still worth a fortune. Thank you for bringing me all this. As for you, Albert, I owe you an apology. I should have trusted you.
You have nothing to do with it. The captain did everything to make me appear guilty.
No. If we put the same trust in the volunteers as in the Seaborns, this would never have happened. We owe you a lot, Desarde. I will not forget it. Nor will I forget the lesson. Be sure of it. You have my full gratitude. Anything else?
I need to be going. Until we meet again, Admiral.
And there you have it. We all ride off into the sunset and roll credits. Okay. Yeah, looks like we got a lot done today. That surprise boss fight there that I didn't really plan on doing, but we ended up doing it anyway, so we'll probably get some treasure, that key we found later. And yeah, we finished a lot of major quest lines as well, so we're doing awesome, considering I'm sick as a dog. We'll see how it goes in the future, but once again, thank you for watching. Remember, I'm on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook, so follow me along there as well, if you dare. Bye for now.